So yeah, Trisha Paytas just made a very emotional video with some serious allegations against David Dobrik and the vlog squad in response to some things that Jeff Wittek said, and we need to talk about it.
And Dom in that group too, sexually assaulting a girl holding her down at VidCon 2 years ago. You all have dirt. You all have dirty, dirty past and dirty, dirty things happening right now. So don't come for me and say I'm disrespecting your sh-.
What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I try to do is take different topics going on in the YouTube community to try to see what lessons we can pull from them to improve our own mental and emotional well-being. And something that I'm really big on is mental health. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And real quick reminder, it is August 22nd. So until the end of the month, my brand new book, Canceled, you can get a free copy at my website. It'll be pinned down in the pinned comment, as well as in the description below. So if you wanna get the ebook for free, there's also an audiobook and everything like that. Anyways, I take a deep dive into YouTube cancel culture, and Trisha Paytas and some situations I even had with her in the past are mentioned in that book if you wanna check it out. So yeah, anyways, I just got some DMs and things like that, like saying, did you see the new Trisha Paytas video? So I just watched it and oh wow. So real quick, I'm in the middle of editing this video. I just wanna hop in. I put this disclaimer at the end of the video, but I wanted to toss it in the beginning just because some people don't watch all the way through. So just real quick, those of you who don't know me, I am not a licensed therapist or a psychologist, but my background is in addiction treatment. I worked in a treatment center for about 3 years. We specialize in dual diagnosis, so we help people with mental health issues as well. I'm a certified life coach, and I have a lot of experience with bad relationships, bad breakups, and all that kind of stuff. So these are just my opinions, all right? So again, if you're new here, my videos are for you, okay? Trisha, if you see this, I feel for you, girl. Like, I want everybody to look at these situations and look at their own lives, because we all just passively watch this content and we don't see how it's affecting us in our own lives. So I want you to see if you can relate to this. Like, I know I can relate to Trisha. Like, here's the thing. Here's the funniest thing, and I've mentioned this in videos in the past. One of the reasons I use Trisha Paytas as an example in my videos is because I can relate so much to her, all right? And I watch this, I'm like, oh man, I used to be like that, or oh, there's still some of those things that I still do. So although I may give some tough love in this video, I do have a lot of compassion for Trisha Paytas and what she went through. Like, her relationship with Jason Nash wasn't great. Their breakup was not great. As Trisha Paytas mentions in this video, as well as in other videos, she did go to a psychiatric hospital. But anyways, yeah, let's discuss. So I wanna talk about a few things, but there is a very serious assault allegation that I'm gonna get to in a little bit. So the first thing I wanna talk about is when we do things based off emotion, all right? So any of you who have been around my channel for at least, I don't know, a few months now, you know that I deleted a video, actually, with Trisha Paytas in the title, even though it wasn't really about Trisha Paytas. But I deleted that video because I turned on this dang camera when I was very, very emotional, okay? That is a topic I actually cover in this book. But this is one of the worst things we can do, not just YouTubers, any of us. When we are running out of emotion, when we're running on emotion, the logical part of our brain, the part of our brain that makes sense, completely goes offline. Like, think about it, just take 1 second, all right? Think about the things that you regret the most in your life and ask yourself, did you do those things based on emotions? Answer's probably yes. Like, this is one of the reasons, like, I do my damnedest to, like, practice meditation and strengthen this beautiful prefrontal cortex that we all have, which is in charge of emotional regulation. It helps us kind of like chill that out a little bit. But like, I empathize with Trisha Paytas in this scenario. So one of the things that I wonder, and like, when I talk, this is kind of how I would talk to a friend, right? Like Trisha Paytas and I, we don't talk to each other. But anyways, if Trisha Paytas was one of my friends, I would look at this scenario and I'd be a little bit concerned because we know Trisha Paytas was going to therapy, like quite a bit of therapy. And I remember like, I was super proud of her. Like she was showing off like her anxiety and depression workbook that she had. She talked about how she had all of these therapists that she didn't really click with in the past, which I can definitely relate to. I know some of you can relate to that as well. She said she finally found an amazing therapist. You know, she was talking about sobriety and recovery and everything like that. And I know she's been on tour lately, but some of those things like she hasn't really discussed in a while. So my question is she still going to therapy, right? Because there are some things that we need to discuss, like, listen. Like, one of the first books I wrote, like, my third book that I wrote was Rewire Your Anger, all right? Like, even though I still get angry because I'm a human, like, my anger used to control me, and I would freak out on people. And something that I've learned in therapy, also in 12-step recovery programs, is to let go of stuff, right? Like, you guys, when we hold on to this anger and this resentment towards our exes, towards people in the past and everything, like sometimes we're just sitting there and we get like angry about somebody in like eighth grade, right? Or we dwell on how our ex hurt us and everything like that. Like it is only causing us pain. Like holding on to that anger is like holding on to a hot coal. That's the way I try to think of it. We gotta just let that stuff go. But we don't want to. And here's what I've realized that a lot of us do and why we hold on to that anger, because we feel we're letting them off the hook. And they need to know how bad they hurt us, right? But the problem is that we all live with our specific perspective of the world, right? Like, when I'm watching like Jeff say those things, like, oh, she screwed over my friend, like that is his perception of the situation. In her mind, like she titled her video, David Dobrik and the vlog squad, like Jason Nash and Jeff and all of them, ruined her life. That is her perspective on the situation. You see what I mean? So like looking back at old relationships, like when I started working the 12 steps, like it was all about me and what I did. It had nothing to do with them. Because if I sit around waiting for other people to apologize or understand how bad they hurt me, I might be waiting around until the day I die. So I hope you all can learn from that. So the other thing is the title of her video, and I get that's how it feels, right? She says, David Dobrik and the vlog squad ruined my life. Like how many of us do that? We say, people ruined our life. This thing ruined my life. Losing that job ruined my life. You breaking up with me ruined my life. Like, this is gonna sound very tough love-ish, and it is, because again, I have compassion for Trisha, but this is my suggestion to all of you. Like, we need to take back control. We have to quit making it as though other people have this control to ruin our lives, right? Because at the end of the day, like, we are gonna get hurt, we are going to feel these difficult emotions, right? But at some point, it is our choice whether we wanna start working on ourselves and moving forward. You know what I mean? Like, I have had many toxic relationships, many, many, many toxic relationships, starting from my first relationships in high school. Like my first three relationships were just the worst, right? Like getting dumped by the girl I thought I was gonna marry just out of nowhere, being cheated on, just all sorts of stuff, right? But now I'm a 34-year-old man. Imagine if I held on to that anger towards them. And I did for a long time. And I brought that anger into new relationships, right? It hurt my future relationships by bringing along that baggage from the previous relationships. And that's why we gotta work on this stuff. You see what I mean? Like, it is doing us no good. Like, something we always have to ask ourselves is this useful to me, right? So like, what I would ask Trisha, if she was one of my friends, or if you were going through it, and you and I were talking, I'd be like, is this useful, right? And no, I'm not a therapist, I'm not a psychologist, I am a certified life coach, but like, I talk to people all the time, especially when it comes to relationships, and we gotta ask ourselves, like, when it's time to move forward and not let that bother us. So the last thing I would say to Trisha before I talk about this assault thing, if I was talking to Trisha, I'd be like, girl, You are killing it right now. All right? Trisha Paytas, girl, you are on tour doing your thing. You got fans coming to come see you. You know what I mean? You're losing weight. Like, you go girl. All right? Do not let these people rent space in your head any longer. All right? Like, what I would tell Trisha or any one of you, the best thing you can do is continue to succeed. Continue to succeed, all right? That's something that moves me forward, right? Like, even though I'm not gonna go and like attack, you know, people and stuff, like what I do is I work on myself, I work on my life, I try to improve things, and that's kind of my like little F you to them, all right? So Trisha, just do your thing, girl. So the last thing I'll talk about is in that video, Trisha said this.
Don't ever say I disrespected one of your friends. Your friends have so much and blood and dirt in their back pocket on their hands. It's disgusting. Including your friend Todd. And Dom in that group too. Sexually assaulting a girl holding her down at VidCon 2 years ago. You all have dirt. You all have dirty, dirty past and dirty, dirty things happening right now. So don't come for me and say I'm disrespecting your.
And yeah, that is a very serious allegation, all right? And it seems like this is happening more and more with public figures, like not even, you know, because we don't know whether or not it's true, but like we saw what happened with Slazo. There was this situation with the guy who did a Screen Rant. I can't remember his name right now, but these are very serious things. And in an emotional state, like this is the first time Trisha's bringing that up. And like, we don't know if it's true or not, but this is something that could be very serious. And David Dobrik obviously has a lot of money and so do his friends. Like he just bought his friend, or he didn't buy his friend a Lamborghini, but he had access to a Lamborghini that he gave him. Like they could sue Trisha like for slanderous statements like that. Like that is a very serious allegation, right? And she did, you know, comment on, you know, Brandon dating his girlfriend while she was underage. So I don't know what's gonna happen with this, but like, ugh, it's not a good situation. But anyways, again, check out the description down below. Check down the pinned comment below. I will have a link to BetterHelp Online Therapy, which I personally use, all right? And like, if you are having difficulties letting go of the past and moving towards the future, like, seek therapy. And I don't care where you get therapy. If you got insurance and you got a therapist in your town, like go seek you some therapy. I talk to my therapist every week and we also message each other and stuff like that. It is a lifesaver, but I also have a support group who can stop me from doing stuff most of the time. All right, anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You're all amazing. And a huge thank you to everybody who buys my books and all that other stuff that helps support me. Thanks again so much for watching. I'll see you next time.